It's been a while since we uploaded our last video, so in this tutorial we are going to speak about controlling brushless motors using an Arduino. For this setup I'm going to use an Arduino Nano, a brushless motor and an ESC with a battery eliminator circuit which is inbuilt of 1 ampere. So the tutorial focuses on instructing this ESC using the Arduino microcontroller to turn this motor at a respective speed, which is to be controlled by using this potentiometer. Also, you can modify the code to suit your requirements. So let's see about the construction of this circuit. First, I need this potentiometer and I'm going to solder 3 wires to this potentiometer and connect it to the Arduino. So let's begin. I have connected 3 wires to this potentiometer. I have done it in a way that when I turn the potentiometer clockwise, the potential difference across the middle pin and the ground will be increased. So that's why I connected the negative pin to this side and the positive pin to the rightmost side of the potentiometer. Next, I will be connecting the pins to the Arduino board. So the positive will be going to the 5 volt output of the Arduino Nano, like this. And the negative will be connected to the ground pin, and I will read the input, the analog input from this potentiometer using the A0 pin, where it can be found here. So I have basically connected the potentiometer to the Arduino Nano. Next step is to connect the brush, the electronic speed controller. So I will be only needing 2 pins from this connector, because in my first case I will be powering the Arduino and Arduino from the computer, so I will be using only the negative and the signal wire from the connector. So I will be using a male to female connector for this task. I will be plugging the negative to the ground of the Arduino board. I can find a ground here, so I will be using that ground like this. Now I have connected the ground of the electronic speed controller to the ground of the Arduino board. Next step is to connect the signal wire to a digital pin of the Arduino. So the signal wire will be the white one from the brushless electronic speed controller, and that one I will be plugging to a digital pin. So in this case I am going to use pin 9. Pin 9 like this. So our wiring is almost complete. Next step is to observe the code and power the motor. So before that I will be connecting the brushless motor to the electronic speed controller. It's simple as connecting the 3 wires using the gold connectors like this. After connecting the wires, make sure that these things do not short circuit during the test. So now I have connected the motor, the brushless ESC. Summary about the connections is, like, we have the brushless motor which is connected to the ESC using 3 gold connectors and like this, and we have the power input for the ESC which is not yet connected, and also we have the connector for the ESC where the signals will be coming. So in this connector I have used only 2 pins. One pin is the signal pin, other one is the ground. The ground of the ESC will be connected to the ground of the Arduino board, and also the signal pin which receives the signals from the Arduino to the ESC will be plugged to a digital pin. In this case I have used digital pin 9 of the Arduino board to instruct the ESC, and also the potentiometer will be provided with 5 volts from the Arduino board and the ground, as well as the middle pin will be providing the analog reference voltage which is used to control the brushless motor for the Arduino Nano. So I have plugged it into the A0 pin. So this is the basic about the summary. Let's do the coding now. So I am going to connect the Arduino board to the computer. using the USB port. In the code, I have first included the server library, which is the default library, the Arduino. So I don't need any additional libraries which is to be downloaded. Next, I'm going to define a servo object. So in this case, I have named the servo as the motor because I'm going to control the motor. In the void setup, I have attached the motor to pin 9 and I have kept a delay of 1 millisecond. And also I have raised the value of the server right to 180 and I have kept a delay of 5 seconds. And also I have lowered the value of the motor to 40 and I have kept a delay for another 5 seconds. This code which is put in the void setup is to calibrate the ESC so that the motor will function accordingly. I have seen this issue many times because of the poor calibration techniques, and this part is used to calibrate the ESC because if you don't calibrate the ESC, there will be a problem and the motor will not start working. In the void loop, I have used motor.write and I have used the map command to read the analog input of the Arduino, and that value will be coming between 0 and 1023, and I need to convert that value to a value between 40 and 180, which is the working range of the ESC, and I have closed the brackets. This is simple as that. Now I'm going to upload the code to the Arduino. I'm clicking upload and the sketch will be compiling like that. Now it's finished, and let's test the code. Next step is to power the brushless ESC. So for that I'm using the bench power supply, and I'm going to connect the positive wire to the positive of the electronic speed controller like this. Make sure that these wires do not touch while you are working with them because there might be a short circuit, and to avoid any dangerous situation. So after connecting the positive and negative, as you can see here, there will be beeps. And next thing what you have to do is you have to make sure that the power supply and the Arduino board will be turned on at the same time, because we can we hold the reset button, because this process is done to calibrate the ESC. So what I'm going to do is when I keep the reset button pushed, and I'm going to turn on this bench power supply. When I'm turning on, I have to release the reset button. This is done so that the ESC will be properly calibrated. So I have released the reset button, and now the motor will be the brushless ESC will be calibrated. And now after the beep set, as you can see, the motor starts spinning. So now with the potentiometer, you can reduce the speed as this, from 0 to the maximum. So this is the basic setup for making a brushless motor turn by using an Arduino and a brushless ESC. So you can turn this potentiometer and make the motor spin according to the required speed. You can also use this code for your own developments as well. The next step, I'm going to show how to power everything without the computer. Now the Arduino board is being powered using the power from the computer, but as the ESC consists of a battery eliminator circuit which is inbuilt, we can use the 5 volt output from this from this ESC to power the Arduino board, as both runs on 5 volts. So I'm going to disconnect the Arduino board first, and also the power source. And next step, I'm going to remove the power, remove the cable from the desktop, and I'm going to use the 5 volt output to supply 5 volts to the Arduino board. So for that, I'm going to use another cable, and I'm going to plug it to the power output from the ESC, which will provide 5 volts to my circuit. So as I have connected 5 volt pin to my potentiometer, I am going to connect it to I am going to connect the 5 volt from the ESC to the 5 volt pin of the Arduino. So as the 5 volt pin is same as here, I can easily connect it to this port. So that's what I'm going to do, so that we can use the same set of wire to provide 5 volt and run the microcontroller using the ESC, so that only one power source will be required for the setup. Now I have connected the 5 volt output from the ESC to the 5 volt pin of the Arduino microcontroller, so there is no any other additional pins, and also the calibration will start as soon as the power is supplied to the brushless ESC. So let's see what will happen. For the safety purposes, I am going to reduce the speed to zero by turning the potentiometer anti-clockwise, and next I am going to supply the power using the bench supply, and after the beeps you can turn on this potentiometer so that the brushless motor will start rotating. The beeping sequence has now stopped. Now if I turn this thing, as you can see, the brushless motor will be powering itself according to the signal we are going to supply for the Arduino microcontroller. So I hope that this tutorial has helped you regarding controlling brushless motors using Arduino. Thank you very much for joining me with the Wikilab channel. We will see you in the next video.